Lately, our Twitter feed was literally full of bottles containing liquid directly from the last chapter of Half-Life. A lot of talented creators made their version of this cool effect. Today, we recreate our version of it on Unity. The effect consists in showing a mesh inside a bottle and make it look like a liquid. To easily care about the lighting, we use a surface shader instead of a fragment. Besides a good aesthetic, to make a mesh looking like a liquid, we have to cut the surface at a certain level. So we started from that point. In our liquid shader, we exposed a position and a normal vector that represent a plane. That plane is the max level of the liquid. Using the dot product between the mesh position minus the plane position and the normal of the plane, we were able to determine which part of the mesh we need to show. We cut out the other part, discarding the color if the dot product is higher than zero. Because we sliced out the mesh, we had divided the front and the back faces. For the front faces, everything was quite simple. We used color, a texture, a normal map, the glassiness and the metallic value. For the back faces, beside the color, the metallic and the glassiness, we needed to transform the normal vector to match the normal of the plane used before. We needed to pretend that the upper border of the mesh was closed and covered the hole. To do that, since we use a surface shader, we had to create a matrix that converts the world coordinate to the tangent space. Also, we use a normal map with the world UV to enhance the refraction while moving. Using a script, we connected the position and the normal of the plane in the shader with a real code. To pretend it to keep the liquid volume inside the bottle, we adjust the position of the quad depending on the bottle rotation. We expose the property called the bottle height. We consider the top of the bottle starting from the base and going up at bottle height distance. We move the quad on this line and we did a proportion to figure out the distance that it has to keep from the base. If the top of the bottle has a lower Y value of the base, we switch them. To approximate the level of liquid in a non-regular shape, we simply use a lower value for the bottle height property. Let's talk about the movement. While the player moves the bottle, we calculate the velocity and keep track of that. We rotate the quad to facing the direction, so the liquid seems to be affected by physics. When the magnitude of the velocity is zero, so nobody is moving the bottle, we use the accumulated velocity to simulate the inertia. With the ping-pong function, we go back and forth from the facing direction to the opposite one. Carrying that value to zero in time allows us to simulate the end of the inertia. We did the same operations even for the angular velocity while the player rotates the bottle. Back in the shader, we interacted with the stencil buffer to cover the back faces and improve the top surface look using also a custom shader on the quad. The stencil buffer allows us to prepare a mask of bit and render an object only if the buffer has the same values. So we need a shader that writes on the stencil buffer and another one that can read from that. In the liquid shader, we divide two cases to avoid covering also the front faces. If you want to go deeper in the stencil buffer, check the description below, and you will find Harry's erroneous article about that. In both of the shaders, we provided a property that represents if the inertia is still present. We use that property in the liquid to animate our threshold in the check visibility function and ruffle the top edges. In the top surface shader instead, we use that property to enhance the normal buff value and faking a ripple. As an additional and optional experiment, we want to allow the liquid material to be transparent. In this case, we drew both faces, back and front, so we decided to use a grab pass. A grab pass is a particular pass that grabs the content of the scene and draws it into a texture. This can be expensive in terms of resources, but it's commonly used when you want to distort an image. We used that in a previous video where we recreated the DIT distortion. After sampling the texture, we use the alpha property of the color as a weight for the lerp between the color and the background texture. We downloaded the bottle model from Sketchfab and we merged the inner meshes to use a single material. This is the final result. If you follow us, you know that in the last weeks, we are working on a framework to create a web augmented reality experience from Unity. So, as the last test, we want to try this on our work in progress framework. Don't forget to subscribe, smash the like button, and follow us on the other socials. Also, if you're interested, you are welcome on our Discord server. See you next time. Cheers!